Special advisor to the president on Niger Delta, Senator Ita Enang, has called for an end to the transfer of 13% derivations to state governors. He noted that the funds should be applied directly to host communities, as he accused governors of Niger Delta of diverting the funds for the purchase of private jets and luxurious cars. Enang made the recommendations while receiving members of the host communities of Nigeria in his office. The 13% derivation is the funds given as compensation to mineral resources producing states. Enang stated that the diversion of the funds is the main reason host communities are vandalizing oil infrastructure. He added that governors in the Niger Delta should only be given the normal federal allocation, while the 13% derivation should be applied directly to develop the oil-producing communities. And joining us live to discuss this is public affairs analyst Alexa Wilcox. Thanks, Mr. Wilcox, for joining us. Yes, and now we're connected again with Mr. Wilcox. Thanks for joining us. So we'd like to find out what your reaction is to this accusation by Ita Enang.
Well, Mr. Ita Enang is not far from the truth. If you look at what has happened to the Niger Delta and the governors with respect to the revision fund, Mr. Ita Enang has been too old in the system for him not to understand what is happening. So it's not far from the truth to the fact that these funds are being mismanaged. But what they are used for is what anybody cannot tell. Because if you see the impute and the result that has come out of the maximum impute that has gone in, then you also know that Ita Enang knows exactly what he's talking about.
And is that a good suggestion for the 13% derivation to go straight to the oil-producing communities?
Yes, the derivation is constitutional. It's 13% of oil revenue that goes to the oil-producing state. Unfortunately, it goes to the state, not the communities. And when it gets to the state, it is going to be turned over by the governors. And so the governors will pass it through the National House of Assemblies as part of their appropriation, and they see it as part of their allocation from the Federation account. They don't see it as a separate fund. They see it as part of the allocation from the Federation account. So they deal with it as normal revenue, rather than dealing with it as specialized revenue that is targeted for specific purposes. Maybe that is where the missing link is. The governors deal with the issue, deal with the funds as part of their revenue profile. And so they can do anything they want with it. They see they have more money, so they do anything they want to do with it without recourse to what the fund is actually meant for.
Let me get your thoughts on the motive for this. Do you also suspect this comment could be politically motivated, or maybe he's playing to the gallery?
But I didn't get that.
Do you suspect that Ita Enang's statement on the 13% derivation could be politically motivated?
No, it can be politically motivated, because if you look at it, there's no APC or PDP in underdevelopment. This governors has been receiving this fund over the years. I think Delta State has an oil mineral producing commission that's supposed to address the need of oil producing communities. With that fund or part of that fund, I know of Delta. I think I also know of Edo. No, sorry, I also know of Ondo that have a similar commission, but I'm not aware that River State, Bayelsa, or Akwa Ibom has such commission, because these are states that receive very large resources. Allocation from that fund, from the derivation fund, which is 13%. So that gives those states far more revenues than their counterparts. For instance, what a state like Akwa Ibom will get monthly from the national account is higher than what the entire southwest state of six states will get. It's higher than what the entire northeast would get. So you discover that there is so much resources, revenue there on account of that derivation. But the output is not the right. That is why you find out that there is more struggle for power there. There is more, insecurity because everybody is scrambling for that form because there's too much money, and they don't know what to do with it. So that is the irony. It's not politically motivated. It is just the fact, the truth on the ground. If you go to the Niger Delta area or the oil-producing communities, you will be amazed that so much money has gone in and nothing to write about. And the people are not complaining because it may be they are being settled or they are being diverted their attention to the fact that their problem is in Abuja. So nobody asks questions. And that is why the governors can run riots with the funds in total disregard of the communities that produce the oil or their states that even need to become better developed and better and better states within the community of states in the country. It's irony, and that is the basic part. Maybe going forward, I wonder what can be done by way of legislation that can correct some of these imbalances. And I think something by way of legislation needs to be done to bring about some sanity in the management of that fund.
Thank you very much for your thoughts, Mr. Wilcox.
It's always my pleasure, anytime. Thank you.
The International Interfaith and Religious Organization for Peace has called for a national day of prayer for Nigeria as the country celebrates its 60th independence anniversary. The interfaith organization gathered at the Unity Fountain in Abuja to pray for the nation ahead of its 60th Independence Day celebration. The national coordinator of the organization, Sunday Garba, asked Nigerians to believe in the unity and peace of the country despite the challenges it has faced.
Nigeria has passed through a lot, but God has kept us as a nation. I believe strongly that Nigeria is a great nation with great potential. I want to ask and appeal to all Nigerians from everywhere in diaspora, in everywhere in the world. Let us believe in this nation. Let us believe in this country. Let us have hope. Let's believe that there is a better country. Let's believe that Nigeria will be great again. Let's put our hands together, praying for our nation. Even coming in the coming of our 60th anniversary, let's believe that it will mark a new beginning in this great nation.
If you look what is happening in the country, really we are going in one kind of dark, which we don't know where we are facing. So we are not late. Still, we are on the way. The country, he needs prayer day and night. Okay? So we have to pray for God. May Allah to accept that. May Allah to cure Nigeria and our leaders and our nation.
Nigeria has passed through a lot.